There are 4 different ways to do sidechaining in FL Studio. One of them is to use automation clips, and all 3 other ones are in this free patcher preset. So you can use all 3 of them at once, or just 1 of them, or 2 of them, or also none of them, I guess, but then you could also just not load it. Anyway, let's get right into it. So before you're loading it, there's already one important thing, which is, as I mentioned, there are 3 different methods for sidechaining in this plugin. And if you want the audio sidechaining to work correctly, before you load the plugin, you have to sidechain the channel you want to sidechain it to the channel the effect is on. So I have a kick here and I want to sidechain the pad to the kick. So just shift click to the pad to sidechain the kick to the pad. And then let's just load it, speedchain. And let's just give it a listen, I would say. I have a little pad here that plays a little melody. As you can hear, there's already an effect applied. This is a sync effect. You can enable or disable it with this button, of course. But let's start from the top. So in this row, we have like master pre knobs. So you can enable or disable the entire plugin with this button. You can adjust the mix for the entire plugin with this one. Then we have a pre-filter. This doesn't actually low-pass or high-pass the signal, but it basically changes which part of the signal you affect with the sidechaining. So let's try that. So let's enable the pumping effect. And if you, for example, only want to affect the low frequencies, you can just apply a low-pass. You can click this button to hear which frequencies you affect now. Or you can also simply disable the filtering with this button. You can also high pass. Yeah, I think that's pretty self-explanatory now. The second row is the audio sidechaining. As I mentioned before, the kick is sidechained to this channel. So the audio we receive will be the kick and it will be sidechained to the kick. So let's try that. You can definitely hear a pumping effect without the kick. It's like this. You have all the classic parameters. Sensitivity basically means threshold. You can make it more sensitive or less sensitive. The amount knob, basically how hard the effect is. And then we have attack, sustain, release. I think those are pretty self-explanatory. Next, we have the sync sidechaining. This is basically just an LFO sync to the beat with a specific sidechaining shape. So let's enable that and check it out. There are 8 different curves you can choose from. They all sound very different. Yeah, you can also adjust the amount, of course. And also some smoothing. This is especially helpful if you get like clicking sounds or something. You can also adjust the rate. So if you have like a halftime beat or something, then you can just adjust it so it fits. Yeah, and the on and off knob, of course. Next is MIDI. So this is an interesting one. You can basically control the sidechaining with a MIDI input. What you have to do for that is simply load a MIDI out. I already have one here. Set the port to 0. The channel doesn't really matter. And then you can just put notes in here. So let's put some notes. I think so it fits the kick. We have to do it like this. Like this. Let's just copy and paste this channel a couple of times. And now if you play it, oh. The moment the signal is basically down all the way, that's because the notes are active all the way. So the length of the note decides how long the signal stays down. So let's shorten them. Or if you make them half the bar. I hope you understand how it works. You can also make a very short one. So as long as these notes are held, we are basically in the sustain stage. And we have all the classical parameters here. We have attack, decay, sustain, release. So you can adjust how exactly the notes affect the signal. And of course, an amount knob and on off. Yeah, I think that's pretty much everything. The great thing about this plugin is that it's really very simple and easy to use. If you want to go more in depth, you can, for example, if you want more than just 8 curves for the sync, if you want to make your own curve, you can go simply in the map and adjust all the curves yourself here, all the 8 curves. And other than that, that's pretty much it. I hope you enjoyed the plugin. Download link will be in the description, of course, and I hope you enjoy.